5.5 digit multimeter how-to video. In this short video, I will show you how the 34450A can perform data logging and subsequently import the logged data into your computer. The data logger features provide a fine panel interface that allows you to perform data logging into the instrument's non-volatile memory.
For today's demo, I have the Agilent 33250A function generator that is set to output a RAM signal to simulate a test condition.
On the 34450A, I have set the multimeter to 10V DCV range at fast mode. Now, let's set the 34450A to perform data logging. First, press Data Log button to enter the Data Log menu. You will come to a list of properties to enter. The trigger delay sets the delay interval between triggers. The sample interval sets the sample interval for time sampling when the sample count is greater than 1. The default value for DCV measurement in fast mode is 69 milliseconds. I will leave it as it is for this demo.
Next, the sample count lets you select the number of readings or samples the meter will take per trigger. In this demo, I will take 40 samples.
The trigger count lets you set the number of triggers that will be accepted by the meter before returning to the idle trigger state. I will do a 1 trigger in this demo. Lastly, let's arm the multimeter through Enable Log. Press Shift again to proceed. Now, the 34450A is waiting for trigger signal to start the data logging. The 34450A can be triggered by pressing the trigger button or simply supply the trigger signal to the serial connector at its rear panel. For this demo, I will use the trigger button to start the data logging. Once the trigger button is pressed, the 34450A will start sampling and logging the values. As you can see on the OLED display, the multimeter is in the progress of logging the values. Notice that the annunciator has disappeared. This indicates that the data logging has completed. To view the log data, press Shift followed by the Data Log button. You can view the log info such as number of records, primary and secondary function and range. Next, the log list shows the list of values logged into the non-volatile memory. Press Shift to find a specific log data, and let's say you're interested in data number 20. Press Shift and it will bring you to the specific data. If you're interested on the distribution of the log data, you can go to the log histogram to view the histogram chart. This is a great feature that lets you instantly know the frequency of occurrence in the measurement range that you have set. Apart from histogram, the log statistics displays the maximum, minimum, and average values along with the standard deviation and number of overloaded samples too.
So, you have learned how to set up the 34450A to perform data logging. Next, you're probably interested on how to import the log data into your computer. Here, I have set up a simple program using Agilent VEE Pro to import the log data from the non-volatile memory into my computer. This is how it is done. First, I set up the VEE Pro program to recognize my 34450A. Then, I use the data points non-volatile memory command to query the number of samples available in the non-volatile memory. Next, I use the data non-volatile memory to read all the data stored in the non-volatile memory to my computer. After I run the program, I will get the number of samples available and the values here. It's a RAM signal as expected from the 33250A function generator.
The data logging function in the 34450A is extremely powerful. It can log up to 14 hours or from 5,000 readings up to 50,000 readings when you purchase the upgrade 3445MEMU. No complicated programmings are needed, and at the end of the logging, you can view values, histogram, and statistic data on the OLED display. You can also transfer log data over GPIB USB or serial port to your computer.
I hope you have learned how to set up the 344-50A to perform data logging through this video. For more information on the Agilent 344-50A 5.5-digit multimeter, please visit www.agilent.com/find/344-50A. Thank you for watching.